It's okay. What's up, guys? This is Alec Mack 111, and today I have an HPA build for you guys. This is a gun that SureShot Midget is doing a mod on, so I have the review. I'm just going to go over and show you the overview real quick of just some of the parts, because I think this looks like a really cool gun if you can't tell. I'm really impressed. So starting at top here is just a normal flashlight. It's actually pretty bright. I don't know if it's any like tactical one, but it's just kind of one of those mounted with a scope ring, which is actually a pretty good way to mount a flashlight sometimes. Light's pretty bright. I'd say it's like 400 lumens, something like that. It's a bright light, and it works fine for indoor. It's on the other side of the grip, which I wouldn't like necessarily prefer because it's kind of hard. You have to take your hands off of it when you're manipulating the gun, but that's just personal preference. Like, some people like to do it differently. I would have a pressure switch running the top just because that's how I like to activate my lights. I like to hit them. I have to run them through one of the Manta rail covers and then just pressure switch it there because I just think that's really cool. But I don't honestly use a flashlight that much either. Up front, we have a mini suppressor. This thing is not very long, as you can tell. It's very short. Just a mini suppressor right there. And then we have a UTG rail cover on this back side. It's just a single UTG rail cover. And then something that I've never even seen before. This is called a Fab Defense, which I've heard of that company before. But this is their PTK grip. And I liked this so much that I literally just ordered one off eBay. It's like an AFG, but it has just a different like grip to it. And then it's a little bit wider. It's skinnier at the top and then wider at the bottom here, and it just feels really, really good because I love like the thumb over bore C-clamp kind of style grip, just because that's how I've always shot my airsoft guns and even like real guns. I don't know, it just feels comfortable to me. I used to run like a vertical grip, and then when I was a noob, I used to hold the magwell, which some of you probably still do, and my dad still does, which is super funny. Next is the Fortis Rev rail. So this is a key mod rail system. I think this looks beautiful. It's actually a real rail. I'd never seen this rail before at all before the gun, and I like it because it's really, really lightweight. You can see how much room there is on there. You have the key mods run through the center here, and then you got the cool Fortis shield with the laser engraving there. That's really pretty. Then you have your quick detach sling points if you want them right there, and then you have your key mod rail segments if you want them, and then it has those two rail segments up front here, which I really, really like. I like how that looks, and it's just clean and smooth. Just feels really good. I mean, the rail is like, this gun is, I mean, it's a HPA gun, so it's not heavy, but it's nice. Next is an Airsoft Junkies body. I wasn't sure what OEM this is, but it's OEM by VFC. I don't know anything about Airsoft Junkies, honestly. I don't know if they custom make HPA guns, which I think they do. They're probably a store, but the body feels really nice because VFC just makes super high quality bodies. I believe GMP or probably VFC have the best bodies. I'd say GMP have the second best bodies in my opinion of like the brands that I've really used. Crytacs have really good bodies too. But the laser engraving on these VFC bodies is just phenomenal. And you have the little logo up there. You can see it's like a skull. And then you have the little logo up, or the little laser engraving right here. And then it has a Valken Outdoor red dot. This is just a standard red dot. They're Valken. I've seen a lot of these. A lot of people run these because they're pretty cheap. It works well. It illuminates. Obviously, just has a little red dot in there. It's not red and green, I don't believe. Yeah, I've used one of these before. It's just a little red dot, but they're pretty nice. And it's one of those very small dots, but it's all personal preference, and it's a pretty nice sight. Like, I like it. I like the T1 style a little bit better, but I think this looks good on this gun, and I like it how it's a little bit further like forward there. Magazine's mine, just standard GMP mags that I run and everything, but it fits really well in these VFC bodies. See, it just fits in, doesn't drop completely because of the ridges on the mag, and they're a little bit old, but it's pretty nice. Next we have a MOE grip, which all-time favorite grips, Magpul PTS MOE grips. I use these on every single one of my guns that I've literally ever had. This is the older gen of this. I don't know if this is gen, I think this is gen 1. This is Gen 1 of the MOE grip, so this is like an old grip. It's not the Maiad, it's the MOE Gen 1. I had MOE Gen 1s and 2s, and then they have their new Magpul grips, which are out, which I like even better than the previous ones. But you can tell the difference between Gen 1 and Gen 2 because of the engraving. The engravings are just thicker on this, and they feel a little bit different. Gen 1 was what I used on my Magpul MOE carbine all the time ago, and then it's funny because this is the exact same thing I used on my first main M4. This is the Magpul MOE stock. These are great stocks. They're all-purpose stocks. They're so good. Great for holding the FCU, which obviously this gun's got a hose. It's great just to have it in there and to use it. You can see that the FCU's right in there, and then they just pull off really quickly. You have to get either a flat head, or if you're strong enough, you can kind of pull this off. I'm not going to do it, obviously, because I don't need to. And then this buffer tube actually has the numbers on it, which is kind of cool. I didn't notice that. It also has sling points here on both sides. I love these little back things. I don't think this is any brand. No, this is just a standard metal one. But this is a nice gun. So obviously you're probably wondering, what the heck is that hose? This is actually an Inferno. It's a different HPA system than your typical Polar Star or your Pro-Tech. But this is a Wolverine Airsoft Inferno. This is one of their new HPA engines. I believe it's a drop-in. Yeah, it's a drop-in for the gearbox, which is kind of cool. I don't know much about the Inferno. I just know that Wolverine's been coming out with a ton of stuff. They came out with the Bolt, the Inferno, and I think there's another one on their engine that they're coming out with. So they're doing a lot as far as HPA goes. And HPA, honestly, is one of, like, a really great gun. I had a Polar Star for a while. There's a chance I might actually be getting a Polar Star MP7, so don't hold me completely to that, but there's a good chance that that'll come out, and there'll be a video on that. Inside, it also has a ProWin and a tight bore barrel in it. Obviously, you want those good shots. This gun is primarily used indoor, I believe. I think it uses it outdoor, too. But you want those tight groupings. And ProWin's, man, ProWin hop-up systems are just so good. You can see it, like, see that shiny blue on the outside of it? They used to be actually like $40, and now they're only like $28 or something on eBike, I think. And I bought one when it was $40, and I was like, oh, this is so good. And then they got much cheaper, which is nice, because they honestly, like, are the best hop-up systems. They look the best. They have very good compression. They hold everything together very nicely, and they work really well with Prometheus purple buckings, which I love, and then flat hop chamber or flat hops that you put in the chamber as well. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this. Let me know if you like this type of video. I love reviewing guns and kind of going over them, because I think, like, new builds are sweet. I love building guns. I used to build a lot more guns when I had a little bit more time when I was not in college, but I'm sure after college I'll have plenty of time. And during the summer I build some stuff too. Like, I built this system this summer. But thanks for watching, guys. This has been AlecNag101, and I'll see you guys later.